USA Radio News with Chris Barnes.
The nation's president-elect is pledging
to every citizen of our land that I will be president for all Americans.
Republican Donald Trump telling his supporters at a New York City rally that Democrat Hillary Clinton had called him to offer congratulations and to concede the presidential race. Though Clinton herself did not make a concession speech, she's expected to address reporters and supporters a little bit later this morning. The Trump camp, including Rudy Giuliani, is thrilled with the results.
This is the people revolting against a Washington establishment that doesn't seem to be able to get anything done, whether it's the president, the former Secretary of State, well, for that matter, a lot of the Congress.
Giuliani says he's feeling very happy for his friend Trump and even happier for his country.
Correspondent Scott Pringle reporting Republicans will also retain control of the U.S. Senate and House. This is USA Radio News. We told you moments ago that Donald Trump's supporters are not surprisingly thrilled at the news of his election victory, but people from Northern California to Seattle to Washington, D.C., who are not so happy with that news, have been filling streets to protest Trump's election. In Portland, Oregon, over 100 protesters are already calling for him to be impeached.
Impeach Trump! Impeach Trump! Impeach Trump! Impeach Trump!
And in Oakland, California, some Trump opponents shut down a train station and burned a Trump effigy. Meanwhile, investors are not thrilled at the news either, as we hear from Nick Bovee.
Donald Trump is trying to reassure the American people, but his election is not reassuring investors. Global stock markets and the dollar are all down. Dow futures are off more than 2%, and the S&P 500 is down almost 2.5%. The London FTSE is also down more than 2%, and Japan's Nikkei is off more than 5%. The Mexican peso plunged more than 13% against the dollar at one point.
This is USA Radio News. President Barack Obama expected to make a statement from the White House later today regarding the outcome of the presidential election. Kellyanne Conway, Donald Trump's campaign chief, says Obama has already sent congratulations to the president-elect. In some of those other races, Todd Young did not just win Indiana's Senate seat, but the Republican beat Evan Bayh very badly. Young winning Indiana's contest to replace Dan Coats by 10 points and says Republican voters took a stand against the status quo in this election.
They believe Washington has become disconnected from our needs and concerns. But tonight, Hoosiers, we together have once again proven that democracy works.
Taking a look at other Senate races, Republican Senator Chuck Grassley of Iowa goes back to the Senate for term 7. In Kentucky, Republican Senator and former presidential hopeful Rand Paul wins re-election. GOP Senators Marco Rubio in Florida, John McCain in Arizona, Rob Portman in Ohio, Richard Shelby in Alabama, Mike Lee of Utah, and Jim Lankford of Oklahoma also winning re-election. In Illinois, Democratic Congresswoman Tammy Duckworth ousted Republican incumbent Mark Kirk, and the longest-serving member of the Senate, Democrat Patrick Leahy, is back for an 8th term. He's held that seat since 1975. And word from GoPro, it's recalling all of its Karma drones because some of the flying cameras have fallen out of the sky. GoPro announcing the recall late last night. For USA Radio News, I'm Chris Barnes.
All aboard!
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the Frank Vetro Show. I am Frank Vetro. What's going on? Let's see. What just happened to my viewers? They're out. Well, hopefully you guys can hear me, or hopefully you guys can see me, because I can't see you or hear you or see what's going on. But anyway, I can't see myself. But Eric can. Okay. Anyway, guys, to keep typing away. I see your comments. Yes, he did it. Yes, he did it. Don't worry about it, Eric. It's okay. But anyway, welcome to the V-Train. Thanks for hopping on this afternoon. That's another quality, good start by Frank Vetro. One of these days, everybody, I will get this thing down pat, and I will be smooth with it. Anyway, right here, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, right here on WLINY.com. FrankVetro.com, Long Island's number one internet radio station. Anyway, I got a bonus cut for you guys today.
Don't mind me.
I got a bonus cut for you listeners today. You can hear that? Then listen to this. In fact, I want President Obama to listen to this. And I want all the Clintons to listen to this. And I want all the liberals to listen to this. I want Amy Schumer to listen to this. Chelsea Handler, get the hell out of the United States. Whoopi Goldberg, take care, brush your hair. Bryan Cranston, Samuel L. Jackson, go away. Lena Dunham, Nev Campbell, hey Cher, take a freaking walk somewhere. Miley Cyrus, go play in traffic. Barbara Streisand, I'll see you in Iraq. Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader, go to Mexico. Al Sharpton, eat shit and live. George Lopez, everybody. Yeah, that's the short list of all the people. Do you remember all the people promising us that they would make a hiatus, get lost, leave the United States? They promised. They swore. They made plans. They had their tickets. Their bags were packed. All the stars, all the pop stars, all the actors, judges, comedians, you name it. They were out of Dodge if Donald Trump won. Well, get the hell out, please. Wow, what would this world be? What would the United States be without Al Sharpton? Oh, how would I love it? Let me count the ways. Yes. Yes, Sherry. He did it. He did it. Now, let me give you a little rehash because, you know, you are listening to Frank Vetro here. There's a bit of an ego here with Frank Vetro, just a little bit of an ego. Now, let's flash back just 24 hours ago. Donald Trump wasn't faring too well at the time. Maybe, I don't know what time it was, around 6-ish, I want to say. I don't know. He was not doing too well in Florida. But the panhandle wasn't showing up for the vote. So, what does Frank Vetro do? Sherry's on Periscope now? That's resourceful, Sherry. I like it. All right, anyway. So Frank Vetro goes on social media, and he wakes up the Florida Panhandle. I don't know. You could say it's coincidence. Say whatever you want. But all of a sudden, after Frank Vetro threatens the Florida Panhandle, Trump makes his move in Florida. Can't win without winning Florida. He wins Florida. I don't know. Maybe Trump owes me a couple of mil. You listening, Donald? I don't know. But tell me, everybody, that wasn't the best. And I have to say, and you go back to past shows, you go back to when Phil and I first hooked up with Eric, when Phil and I were on LI News Radio, from the time Donald Trump took a trip down that elevator in Manhattan and announced his presidency, Phil, me, Eric, we said he was going to win. When he was at his lowest, we said he was going to win. That's all I can tell you. So, not that I'm patting myself on the back. Obviously, there was a few other people, a few very famous people, you know, all over, you know, news. There was a handful that were behind him the whole way also. But I have to tell you, 98% of the people were not. Not the whole way. Not like I was. I can tell you that. Not like Phil was, Eric. We were with them. I mean, I knew it. I just knew it. So anyway, man, what a night. I was up the whole night, waited till the end. Man, it was something else. It was just, it was good to know that what I said. Well, I guess I was not completely right, because I said he'd win pulling away. Well, hey, time out. Now that I think about it, he was pulling away. With the electorals. It was nothing like, and how good was it? How, what a vision it was yesterday. I hate to say it. What a vision when they were showing split screen of the Republican Party that was about to take place and the Democratic Party from the Javits Lecture Center in Manhattan, and Donald Trump was just a couple of blocks away. And did you see the sight of the Democratic? They looked like they were in a concentration camp. People crying, people on the floor, people leaving. It was empty. It was like, my God. It was just amazing. To me, it was amazing. I don't know. Donald Trump, the man everybody underestimated. And, you know, they try, a couple of people, they wanted to equate it throughout, at least after he won the primary, to Ronald Reagan. Ronald Reagan was a Democrat turned Republican. Labeled like an outsider. Hollywood actor, can't do it. Media didn't like him too much either. Didn't want him to win. Went on to become one of the best presidents ever. This is more amazing. And here's why this is more amazing. I mean, way more amazing. See, Ronald Reagan was in California. He had some type of a base. First, he was a Hollywood actor, and he was a governor. He dipped his foot in politics before, and I don't mean just low-level politics. He was the governor of California. Okay, he did something, then ran for president. And if that wasn't special enough, Donald Trump never did a damn thing. Never did anything in politics. I mean, he's a reality star, but he wasn't a Hollywood star like Reagan was. In fact, Donald Trump rubbed people the wrong way, if nothing else, unlike Reagan. And he did it. And it was Donald Trump v. the world. All right, Donald Trump v. the world. He had to take on the Democrats. He had to take on the Bernie Sanders front and all the millennials. He had to take on the media. He had to take on his whole freaking party himself. They were against him. The Republicans. The establishment. They were against him. They're all against him. And they all underestimated him. And I remember, and I said this a million times already, I remember after the very first debate, this pundit, this expert, said he just watched the decline of a presidential campaign. Trump was done. He was a clown. How many people called him an idiot? How many? Well, guess what? He's smarter than every one of them. Smarter than every last one of them. He's a clown. He's not qualified. Well, for somebody who's not qualified, let me tell you. You see the list? First of all, he 16 seasoned politicians in the primaries alone. Beat them all. Say what you want. Unorthodox, he said this. How dare he say that? The media, whatever you want to say. He outsmarted every freaking one of them. And I said the whole way, when everybody was calling him a jerk and an idiot and a clown, how could you call this man a clown? He's smarter than every one of us. Then he took on the Democrats. Then when the media, and how positive is this man? And I tell you, for a 70-year-old man, he does have energy. Traveling 5-6 states a day. Keeps on going. He outwitted everybody. A man with no political experience, taking on the entire political establishment. And every time he said something, he's wrong. And they came back more fierce against him. his own people, the Democrats hammering him down, the media hammering him down. Then he would say something else. He's wrong. This is rigged. He's wrong. The media is doing this. He's wrong. Hillary, he's wrong. He was right every single time. And he never backed down. I love it. He never, ever backed down. You want to fight? I'll fight harder. You want to go to the gutter? I'll go to the sewer. No, I don't back down. Yeah, I am a counterpuncher. I will punch back. Well, that's not presidential. You started the fight. We need a little more of that mentality. This lay down mentality, I'm not for it. He fought. And he didn't say things just to win votes. In fact, he would be asked the same question 2-3 times. And when he was done answering and he knew it was wrong, he'd be asked again. And you know what? He'd give the same answer. We knew where he was coming from. Yeah, he stumbled. Of course he did. A couple of things, whatever. You know, ah, man, Jesus. But you know what? He outsmarted every single one of yous. Don't forget that. You know, just like those the counterfeiters and the scammers and the identity theft, the hacks. What happens when they get caught by the FBI? They give them a job. Come work with us. You're the best at it. Well, maybe this is what the government needed. Hey, Donald Trump, obviously we can't keep up with you. Obviously the Republicans, the Democrats, and every other party, and the media. We all tried. It's quite evident. It's 100% evident that they all tried to take him down. And little old Donald Trump. Well, not little old, but Donald Trump, all by himself, took you all down. He beat you. Even yesterday, he wasn't supposed to win. No, he wasn't supposed to win. Forget it. No way. Donald Trump can't win. But he did. And he came back. And you know, the percentage for Hillary to win. And Donald Trump. But then as he wins another state. And then another state. And then another state. And the odds. And the odds. And everything's starting to shift. And you see it. And you felt it. And man, and he won Wisconsin. Oh, God. He won Wisconsin. I couldn't get enough of it. I have to tell you. I could not get enough of what was going on yesterday. Let me tell you right now. Oh. He beat every single one of them. But he's a clown. He's a clown, everybody. Well, if the FBI didn't release that letter 2 weeks ago, week and a half before the election, he was down a lot. I don't know about that. I'm not quite sure about that. Who says he was down a lot? The polls? You know what I say about the polls all the time. You know what they say about the polls all the time. And I'll get more into the polls later. But to me, hey, by the way, you know, I was watching Fox News. Did you see Tucker Carlson go at it, attack, and I mean justifiably, Karl Rove? Okay, Karl Rove basically says that Trump should thank Paul Ryan. Oh, yeah, Trump's going to thank Paul Ryan. He should thank for campaigning. And Tucker Carlson goes at it. I like Tucker Carlson. Goes at it with him. I haven't seen him since. Maybe I'm just not paying attention. Okay? See, to me, I'm no expert. See, Clinton never made sense to me. Never made sense to me. She's been in office forever. She's been around politics forever, having been the first woman of President of the United States and the first woman of Arkansas, married to Bill Clinton. And the trail of nonsense. It's on a very basic level. You didn't do your job and you were careless, even if there were no charges. You were very careless, extremely careless. And you were caught in numerous lies. when you mess up at your job, you don't get promoted. That's just it. Forget the history. Forget anything. Forget policy right now. I mean, I'm just thinking about it on a very basic level. She messed up. She messed up. And when you mess up, hey, they put forward a tainted candidate. And when you mess up, you don't get promoted. That's it. Basic. Basic level. None of us would be. She really botched things. Not to mention, she didn't get anything done her entire career. And we all know, you guys listen to me fairly religiously. I've been asking for months and months now, what has she done? Nobody's ever answered me because she hasn't done anything. And how about at the end of the night, everybody, if you guys were able to stay up when the Clinton campaign didn't know what to do and John Podesta, her manager, has to go down to the Javits Center, but Hillary doesn't follow him. Hillary doesn't follow him. She stays back. She can't face the crowd. A real leader. She sends him to talk to them. A leader goes down and delivers good news, bad news, bland news. You go there. You fight with the people. They're standing there all night for you, Hillary. See, nobody addresses this. I see it. I'll call it for what it is. That's not what a leader does. She shouldn't have sent her crony out there to do her dirty work. You go there. They're there for you. They made sacrifices for you for years. With your ground game, the Clinton machine. But when it was late, ooh, it's too early in the morning, and it's not looking too good, let me stay behind. No, you suffer with your followers. With the people who gave it up for you. You don't stay back. You speak to them. You lead them. And a leader will lead their troops to victory, or they'll be with them when they lose. And you bailed out. See, that is the trying moment right there for a leader. And we've all heard it. You judge a person not how they are when times are going well for them, but how are they when times are bad? How are they when it's rough out there? How was Hillary when it wasn't looking so good? She stayed back. She stayed back. And that, to me, sums it up. And you can say all you want. Well, Trump would have did that. This president did that. The other person who ran for office did that. And this one did that when he lost. And it always happens. And that's how they always do it. Well, if that is how they always do it, well, then they always do it wrong. But that fits the whole narrative, doesn't it? We want change. We don't want the way it's always been. That was a defining moment for me. That summed it all up. I swear to you, I was in bed watching this happen, and I'm thinking, look at this crap. She won't even show up to talk to her people. Shame on her. She sees them in the crowd. She knows they're there crying. She knows that she has followers wiped out, laying down on the floor. In tears, heartbroken, beside themselves, distraught. She bailed out on them. You bailed out, Hillary. That's how you will be remembered to me. You bailed out. Yeah, she had her little speech today. Blah, 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 blah. I don't buy it. It was so, I don't know what, so programmed. So programmed. Typical. Ah, she disgusts me. She does. She disgusts me. Anyway, hey, you listen to the Frank Vetrell Show every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, right here at 4:30. WLINY.com, Long Island's number one internet radio station. We got some hope, everybody. We did it. We can be heard. We can be heard. I got to pay some bills. I'll be back in a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. Maybe go crack open a beer, go get a soda, go get something. I'm staying here. You better too. Back after this.
ShowMeCountry.com. It's not just a brand, it's a
lo- hello?
Wait, what do you mean? We're not doing it this way?
Stop it. No, we're not.
All right, fine.
ShowMeCountry.com.
Express your country with great products like purses, hats, shirts, belt buckles, purses, wallets, novelties, and gifts.
We have something for everyone. Hundreds of products, adding new deals daily.
Their site is 100% safe and secure.
Easy payment options like login with Amazon, PayPal, or credit debit cards.
Country means something different to everyone. Show off your country style with ShowMeCountry.com.
Not country? Check us out anyway. Custom orders welcome.
ShowMeCountry.com.
It's not just country, it's a lifestyle.
So check out our buddies at ShowMeCountry.com.
An extraordinary story of a real-life David versus Goliath is told as Frank Vetro, a young charismatic principal on the rise of the educational system, has his life taken away like you won't believe. In Standing on Principle, Vetro provides a first-hand account in real time of an innocent man in the justice system and details the tedious struggle to clear his name. You will never hear another story like it. It broadens from local themes right here on Long Island to global themes of social political importance. Learn the struggles of Frank Vetro as a career was lost, as well as employment and his home. For more information about the book, go to frankvetro.com.
Hey guys, it's Eric from Cop and Calamity in the Morning. Let me talk to you for just a second about Harlequin Capital Corp. See, when you're shopping for a mortgage for either buying a home or refinancing your home, you don't want to deal with a company that's going to string you along day after day, only to find out when it's all the dust settles and you hit that closing table that what they promise is not what's there. Nope, that's not Harlequin Capital Corp. See, they have integrity in closing. They know the mortgage business. They know their products, and they know what they have to do to ensure that you get the best mortgage at the best rate and a rate you can afford. They know their stuff. Harlequin Capital Corp. 888-815-1120. 888-815-1120. One more time. 888-815-1120. Call Harlequin Capital Corp. for all of your mortgage and refinancing needs today. They know their business. And that's what you need to know. Harlequin Capital Corp. 888-815-1120. 888-815-1120. Give them a call today.
Goodbye, establishment. Goodbye, Obama. Good riddance. Just ride off into oblivion. Hillary Clinton, please. Please. Yeah, what's up with those riots? Impeach Trump. What a bunch of morons. Yeah, we're going to impeach Trump. What are we impeaching him for now? I forgot. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. So the other day, by the way, guys, I was did a little speech. Me and my friend Jeffrey Deskovitz, spoke for just a few minutes at John Jay College of Criminal Justice. We're talking about the injustices in the justice system, the legal system. So speaking to some future graduates, always good to speak in front of the youth of America, let me tell you right now. And, God, I get such energy when I'm in front of them. So that was a great, I tell you, it was it wasn't long, just a few minutes, and let me tell you something. I have to do more of that, because I have to wake up America to what's going on in the criminal justice system, and hopefully we can influence these future attorneys and criminologists and get these right the ship, put it that way, right the ship. So that, I was at John Jay College, and I want to thank them for the opportunity to speak there. Hopefully I get to do some more of that. But Yeah, what's up? Did anybody really think? I mean, what really came of this? The stock market is crashing, going down like the Titanic last night, right? As Trump is winning the election. Did anybody really think that the United States was going to fold? I was watching it with my niece, Sophia, and I'm like, watch this. Somebody's going to get rich off of this. And what happened to the Dow Jones today? It's at numbers that it's never seen before. What does that tell you? What does that tell me? What I told my niece last night. Somebody's making money. Not Frank Vetro. He's not the one making money. Not the common man. It's not the people that are downtrodden in Cleveland. The streets of Detroit. Not those people. Crashing like the Titanic. Low, low. So what do wealthy people do? What do people have all this money? They bought low. And look at now. They bought real low. It's at all-time high. The Dow Jones is at highest levels in history. They're making money. Isn't that what Trump got in trouble for? Didn't everybody in the media and everything, didn't they get come down on Trump because when the real estate market was low, like really low, like crashing, he bought everything up and Hillary Clinton said, how dare he take advantage? He took advantage. Here's one perfect example of how they brought up absolutely nothing stories and the sheeple, the blind sheep in the herd were listening. Oh yeah, he took advantage. What do you mean he took advantage? He's a real estate developer. He bought real estate. He bought it low and he sold high. Just like they did between last night and today. It was crashing low, sinking fast because Trump was winning. And now look at it. You mean to tell me that the wealthy people of the world, the people that know what's going on in the stock market, didn't start buying up stock, didn't start soaking it up? And now look at it. Of course they did. Don't kid yourself. And that's what people do when you have money. You got money to spare, you make money off of that. Please. Anybody with half a brain predicted what was going to happen? Yeah, it's dropping. It's going to watch what happens tomorrow. Same thing happened with the Brexit, didn't it? Remember that one a few months ago? Same exact thing, and somebody made money. That's what they do. But Trump, boy, he took hell. God forbid Trump does it. Everybody does it. I would have done it if I had money to spare. I would have called up my broker too. Unbelievable. So, they won the House, retained the Senate. Republican all the way now. Should get things done, right? Things should get done, you would think, right? Hopefully they could work with Trump and vice versa. They work together. I'm hoping they do at least. Hang on one second, everybody. Eric, you don't have to bother. Really. Really. It's okay. See how Eric is trying to look out for me this whole time? He should have been gone a half hour ago, everybody. Feel bad. So hopefully some things get done now. Now, everybody's worrying about, you know, Obama's legacy, his legacy, and this and that. And, you know, he went on and he's talking about a peaceful transition and they'll abide by the 240-year tradition. Blah, 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 blah. He's kind of dismissive of Trump. Kind of dismissive. I'm telling you, Trump doesn't get enough credit. I don't care what anybody says. The man's a genius. And don't kid yourself if you think he's not. And I think he's going to make good decisions. I really do. Yeah, I hear you. I hear you. You're right. Trump speech, quote, Trump better behave in the transition. Like I said, kind of dismissive. You know what? He's smarter than you. And you know what? If anybody was unqualified for president, it's Obama. I think he's the worst president in the history of the United States. I really believe that. I mean, wholeheartedly. He's one of them. He's one of them. And what are the qualifications for president? Is there a resume? Is there a job description somewhere where this is the basic qualifications? You want to be a teacher in New York State? You need a master's degree. That's one qualification. Permanent certification. You have to pass some state exams. I could give you the certification requirements. What is it to be the president? Because guess what? Obama wasn't qualified. What was he? Some type of event planner, whatever the hell he was. He was nothing. First term state senator, nothing. Oprah Winfrey got him elected. I can tell you what about Obama's legacy. Hopefully Trump follows through and he repeals how many were there? Executive orders that he got passed with nothing more than his pen, maybe a phone call. Let's get those executive orders and tear them up. That's your legacy, Obama. Obamacare, wipe your butt with it. And I tell you who takes a real hit. Did you hear them talking about the polls yesterday? These political experts, did you hear them talking about the polls as Trump was winning? Where's Pennsylvania? There was no, the entire election he wasn't winning Pennsylvania. He was not supposed to, he was never up in the poll with Pennsylvania. But he won Pennsylvania. What have I been telling you people since day one of this election? Since day one, March, April 2015. What is Frank? And you can't tell me no. You keep going to the tape. Go back to all my past shows. They're accessible. You tell me when every single episode I said, don't pay attention to the polls. Do not pay attention to the polls. They're not accurate. Forget it. And it was shown to be a little rigged, right? Polling a few Democrats. And I always said, this little snapshot in some town somewhere. What does it have to do with the pulse of the United States? Nothing. And that's the same exact thing they said yesterday. Because all their polls were failing. And oh, the margin of error, margin of error. You know, you shouldn't be having a margin of error of 4 or 5 anyway. 6. 3.5. What I tell you, they all have to come together so they're accurate for the next election. Don't pay attention to the polls. Really. I think the polls took a hit. Next, don't have short-term memory, everybody. Don't pay attention to the polls. They are not accurate. I don't care what anybody says. Anybody. And it shows. He was never leading Pennsylvania in the polls. Never. But he won Pennsylvania. And then the list goes on and on. The polls are there. They use them to sway you. They use them to sway you. And that's it. You know who else took a hit? The media. If you guys ever, don't ever forget how the media was outed 96% against Trump, financially speaking. All of their donations, Democrat. The time spent on Trump stories, unsubstantiated stories, 96% to say 4%, 3%. No time spent on Hillary, the negatives. Always Trump. Negative. Beating them down. You just can't listen to the media. You can't believe them. They're not trustworthy. And I think they've shown it. And they've done it to themselves. I wrote all about it in my book. By the way, I wrote a book, Standing on Principle. Yeah. PAL. I think he's going to be good. Samuel L. Jackson. Get out of this country. Neve Campbell, drop dead. Lena Dunham, go away. Miley Cyrus, go play in traffic. Barbara Streisand, go to Mexico. Everybody that said you're getting out of the country. Jon Stewart. Amy Schumer. Samuel Jackson, Chelsea Handler. Chelsea Handler, she's insulted. You know what this woman has said in her time or done? Don't tell me that she's repulsed by Trump. There's just no way. Al Sharpton, Go spend time with ISIS. Why? Listen, you said you were going to leave. Leave. And when I say leave, you know, you all say you're going to Canada all the time. Why Canada? Why don't you go to Mexico? You don't like what Trump said about Mexico? Go there. Go help them out. Why you got to go to Canada? Go to Mexico. They need you. Go. You feel bad for the Syrians? Huh? Or the refugees? They have it rough? Go help them. They need your help. You guys all have money. You're all successful, right? Pop stars, actors, actresses, famous comedians. Take your wealth. No problem. You know what? I don't mind. Go away. Go help the refugees. Go to them. Go to them. Help them. What are you waiting for? You said you were, or you just lying to everybody. Just like Hillary. The media was exposed. Actually, I exposed the media, but Trump did it on such a large level. All right, listen, I got to take a quick break. When I come back from break, I got one final word to say, and then we're going to talk about moving forward, what needs to be done. And then, believe it or not, I do have some criminal justice stuff to talk about. I got to pay a couple of bills, a few commercials. You listen to the Frank Vetro Show. I am Frank Vetro. Here every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 4:30 Eastern Time, right here on WLINY.com. Long Island's number one internet radio station. We'll be back right after this. Harlequin Capital Group.
Hey guys, it's Eric from Cop and Calamity in the Morning. Let me talk to you for just a second about Harlequin Capital Corp. See, when you're shopping for a mortgage for either buying a home or refinancing your home, you don't want to deal with a company that's going to string you along day after day only to find out when it's all the dust settles and you hit that closing table that what they promise is not what's there. Nope, that's not Harlequin Capital Corp. See, they have integrity in closing. They know the mortgage business. They know their products, and they know what they have to do to ensure that you get the best mortgage at the best rate and a rate you can afford. They know their stuff. Harlequin Capital Corp. 888-815-1120. 888-815-1120. One more time. 888-815-1120. Call Harlequin Capital Corp. for all of your mortgage and refinancing needs today. They know their business. And that's what you need to know. Harlequin Capital Corp. 888-815-1120. 888-815-1120. Give them a call today.
ShowMeCountry.com. It's not just a brand, it's a...
Hello?
Wait, what do you mean? We're not doing it this way?
Stop it. No, we're not.
All right, fine.
ShowMeCountry.com.
Express your country with great products like purses, hats, shirts, belt buckles, purses, wallets, novelties, and gifts.
We have something for everyone. Hundreds of products, adding new deals daily.
Their site is 100% safe and secure.
Easy payment options like login with Amazon, PayPal, or credit debit cards.
Country means something different to everyone. Show off your country style with ShowMeCountry.com.
Not country? Check us out anyway. Custom orders welcome.
ShowMeCountry.com.
It's not just country, it's a lifestyle.
So check out our buddies at ShowMeCountry.com.
Welcome back, everybody. Frank Vetro Show. Listen, guys, I'm glad you're watching this right now because I'm opening up a package. I don't know if you see me fumbling around with this. Got something in the mail, and I like to shake things up, see if something's ticking inside of it. Looks like a book, though, but in case I blow up or some type of anthrax powder spills on me or something like that, you guys can be witnesses to this. All right? So I'm trying to open this. I don't know what the hell it is, to be honest with you. Yeah, it's a book. Oh, yeah, this is the guy I'm supposed to interview in a little bit. I guess I'm going to survive this one, everybody. All right, got the book. Very good. All right. I survived. No anthrax on me. So that's the good news. You know, speaking of people up to no good, there's a guy, Alfred James, lives right here. Lives in, right here in Long Island. He's a retired Suffolk County police officer. And you guys all know about James Burke. I talk about him all the time. Really corrupt. He's doing about 4 years in prison right now. The feds cracked down on him. Highest ranking uniformed police officer in Suffolk County. The most corrupt man you'll ever meet in your life. Him and his buddy Thomas Porter, who's still in office, somehow still working, employed as the DA right here in Suffolk County. I don't know how, but he is. So anyway, he's in jail. He's done a lot. I can't read the list. Not enough time. I got to talk about something else. But you want to talk about a long laundry list of corrupt behavior. And now he's locked up. And this guy, retired cop, says, there are many in the community who recognize the work for former Suffolk County Police Chief James Burke did as a law enforcement official and his commitment to the people he served. Oh, my God. You give me a break. He spent many hours of his own time protecting people and communities. Yeah, the women he was having sex with, that he was cheating with. While I believe he should be held accountable for the mistakes he made and that Newsday has every right and obligation to report the story comprehensively, I would hope that the newspaper could differentiate between his mistakes and the alleged corruption of elected officials in Nassau County. Listen to me. You listen close to me. All you police officers and DAs and the 80 people who wrote letters on his behalf to the judge. I understand that nobody wants to be judged by their worst moment in time. He didn't just make one mistake, got a DWI. He didn't just arrest the wrong person. He didn't just beat up one victim in a fit of rage. Split second decision. His corruption went on for years, decades, premeditated. He spent hours destroying people. And you don't want him to be judged just on his mistakes? Here's the point, Alfred James, retired Suffolk County police officer who worked with James Burke. These weren't mistakes. You hear me? He didn't make a mistake. He did this. He planned it. He planned every corrupt act he did. It wasn't just poor judgment. He's a corrupt bastard, and he should be in jail for 25 to life. You hear me? Alfred James, retired Suffolk County police officer. See how mad I get? These people, they got some nerve. Yeah, you don't want to judge people. Nobody wants to be judged. We all make mistakes. This guy, James Burke, didn't make a mistake. Who the hell are you kidding? What's the mistake? How many times did he wiretap people? He wiretapped police officers. He wiretapped the feds. Is that a mistake? Was that a mistake? Wiretapping the feds? Wiretapping police officers? Where's the mistake? He planned it. Don't you ever say James Burke made a mistake. He planned it. He planned to destroy lives. Belongs in jail forever. Ever. He's a two-bit punk that had a badge and a gun. And he used it so he could be a bully. And he should be brought up on RICO charges. Like they do with the mafia. Organized crime. All right. God, it gets me so worked up, I can't even stand it. Whew. Now, here's where I'm probably, if I didn't already, I'm probably going to make some enemies. This whole thing about peaceful transition, Trump should take the high road, move on. He should do presidential things and not waste his time on petty things to go after people that were against him during his election run. For example, he shouldn't prosecute Hillary Clinton. Don't do it. Are you out of your mind? Don't prosecute. What? Listen. Here's what he should do. Just get some independent party. Get some independent people. No ties. Impartial. Put together a grand jury. Something. Do it the right way. Investigate this woman. The Clinton Foundation, hopefully they keep investing. He better go after her. There's reason to investigate. There's enough out there where it's like, wait a second, we can't just let this go now. The election's over, we can't let it go. Obama was never going to do it. The people in office, the current attorney general, the waste of time, she was never going to do it. Now he's in office. We have Republican Senate, House. He has to invest. I'm not even saying go after her and prosecute her. Do that investigation and do a thorough investigation and be relentless and never let up, because there's a lot of evidence that she really screwed over the United States and raped the citizens of the United States. He better go after her. He better investigate. I'm telling you right now, he has to do that. For our own sake. He has to. And if you do it the right way, thoroughly, not for political reasons where you're going to just, you know, you're in her pockets, favors, and we're going to let her off. Oh, she was careless, this and that. No, really do it. And if the evidence shows, then you prosecute. And everybody covering up, you take them down too. That's what's called draining the swamp, Mr. Trump. Do not take your foot off the gas pedal. Don't listen to any of these morons. Oh, he's got to move on. Bullshit, move on. Bullshit. You don't move on. And I tell you one other thing that maybe nobody wants him to do. Nobody except Frank Vetro. Because Frank Vetro went through what he went through in this one little aspect. And if you read my book and you know about my life and what happened to me, you'll know. All these women came forward doing 1 hour, 45 minute interviews on CNN. They came forward, all these unsubstantiated stories, how Trump groped them and kissed them and this and that. Nobody ever solidified any of their so-called facts, but they got plenty of airtime. And this is a presidential election run where they were tarnishing his reputation and it was having an impact on him. And he may have lost. He could have lost. He stayed strong. He was smaller than everybody else. But that's not the point. There was damage. And let me tell you something. Back in 2006, a bunch of people came forward. And I was charged. Frank Vetro. Unsubstantiated claims. Unsubstantiated claims. And they came forward. Frank Vetro got arrested and lost his ass. I was ripped apart in the media. They never got my side of the story. Just like they never got Trump's side of the story. They just ran with all these stories and gave all these women all this action. Wrote a book about it. Next thing you know, Frank Vetro's living in his car. He went from high school principal to homeless, living in his car because of unsubstantiated claims, and the media gave it play. And I was a terrorist on the news. And I was the commercial for the news channel. And I was in Riverhead Jail wearing a jumpsuit. Unsubstantiated. Never proven. To this day, never proven. Well, this can't happen. And these women came forward against Trump. Oh, he's going to spend his time in the White House filing lawsuits against the women? No. Attorneys do that. He won't even see it. If anybody knows how legal cases go, believe me, Trump's never going to see it. He has a couple of private attorneys. Go sue them. No, he's not going to be bothered with it. It's not going to take time away from his presidency. It's not going to have anything to do with that. Believe me, anybody that thinks if Trump sues these women, oh, that's what he's going to spend his time on, he won't have to put one thought into it. Believe me when I tell you, I've been in the system. I've been fighting things for 10 years now. He won't spend a second thinking about it or wasting his time with it. He has attorneys to do that. If these women were not telling the truth, then there needs to be consequences for that. You cannot have people, man, woman, regardless, going to the media with our interviews, defaming somebody's character, I don't care, public figure or not, with things like that, when they're running to be the president of the United States, and they're going to say that they were groping you, you better back that up. You better back that up. So why let it go? I want to know. Somebody tell me, why should he let it go? Because it's not presidential? Forget, keep it aside. Forget presidential. You can't, just the concept. And why not expose this at the highest level to warn anybody, any guy that wants to come out with a story, any girl. Listen, I wrote a book. I named every goddamn name there is. You know why? Because my story's true. Unlike the people against me, I told the truth. Book's been out for almost 3 years now. Not one lawsuit because it's true. I'll take them on. You cannot have people saying things in the media where people are being, I don't care, famous or not, people are being defamed, the slander, the libel. Could have cost them the election. There needs to be consequences. And if these women are afraid, then good. Be afraid. Don't just come out and think, I'm going to say this about somebody and there'll be no consequences. That's crap. And if you don't agree with me, then you know what? It never happened to you until you get defamed, until somebody comes out in the media and says, you did this and you did that. Then when you learn how it feels to lose sleep at night, to have anxiety, everybody's talking about you. You're in the media day after day after day for something you didn't even do because people are the stigma, what they are doing to you. When that happens to you, then you tell me about it. Donald Trump should sue those women. Win or lose, he should sue those women so they know how it feels and they regret their actions. And you pass the word down and you let it be known that you don't come out with false accusations. It destroys life. Fine, it's Donald Trump. He didn't lose anything. That's not the point. He should sue the media. Did they do any fact-checking before running with the story? Rolling Stone just lost the lawsuit, right? Remember they ran that article about the rape? The girl who claimed she was raped? No justification. No fact-checking. Just believed the woman. So they print the story and printed it again. Turns out the administrator, who they made to look like an animal, didn't do anything wrong. She just won, what, $3 million after winning the case? Because Rolling Stone was held liable. Maybe these networks and this mainstream media, these print outlets, maybe they should be sued for giving those women any playtime. Maybe they're liable. Where's the facts? Did they document anything? To say that he should never sue these women and he should just act like a president? Well, in my eyes, acting like a president is preventing injustices from happening again. And if Donald Trump sues them and makes a point at the highest level, the highest visibility, maybe the rest of it'll send a message to the rest of the people, men and women. You don't come out with false accusations. You better back it up. And the rest of the media, by the way, also, you don't run stories without any proof. I'm tired of it. And he should sue those women and screw them. And if everybody thinks that's childish on his part, then screw you too, because you don't know what it's all about. When it happens to you, then you tell me what you think about that. That is bull. All right, everybody. Always get me ranting and yelling and all this nonsense, right? All right, you've been listening to the Frank Vetrell Show. Listen, before I leave, guys, man, it's already 5:30. I had more to talk about. All right. Anyway, before we leave, we have a show coming up on Friday. It's at 9 o'clock Friday night. It's called The Politics of Love. Great show. Okay? Great show. And Rebecca Kennedy, that's the hostess. Okay? Beautiful woman. And it's kind of the show, I'm sure you heard it before, it's kind of like Dr. Ruth, remember her, little old lady? It's kind of like Dr. Ruth meets Delilah, and she talks about sex and relationships, and she does it, it's no holds barred, man, make a truck driver blush. 9 o'clock Friday night, so you people that are out there, you don't have a date Friday night, and you're just sitting around, I know you're going to turn her on, I think she's going to turn you on, actually. It's a great show, it's going to stand, it's good conversation. I could say it might be a little erotic once in a while. I don't know. Tune her in. 9 o'clock Friday. You're going to love it. I'm telling you right now. I was a guest on her show when me and her were on another network, actually, on Terrestrial Radio. And let me tell you, that was a great episode. And I know she's going to have a great run here. Politics of Love, Friday, 9 o'clock. But I'll tell you all about the show. this Friday, actually. So, anyway, that's the Frank Vetrell Show, man. Hey, I've been following. Listen, you guys have been saying some nice comments about me over here. I've been listening. Thank you, Sherry, Tammy, everybody. Of course, I just lost everything. But whoever was saying nice things, I just lost it. Thank you. You can catch my book, frankvetrell.com, frankvetrell.com. The book is standing on principle. Learn everything about me at the website. Contact me, by the way, social media. Contact me through my website like most people do, and I always respond personally. I check my own email, and I will promise to get back to you. If you need help, if you're getting run through the system, somebody just reached out to me last week again, needed help. They needed advice on, you know, how to find an attorney. No problem, man. I could tell you how to find. For a non-attorney, nobody's spoken to more attorneys than me. I could tell you that right now. I'll tell you exactly what to do. Been there, done that. My goal in life, I vowed that if I survived what I was going through in my car, that I would help people get through what they're going through, because it's lonely out there, man, when you're going through the system. So let me tell you, reach out to me. You need any type of advice, I'll do my best to answer you. I'm not an attorney. Want to make that disclaimer, you know, with this legal advice and stuff like that. I'm pretty good with the law, as the people who are closest to me can vouch for. They always tell me to take the bar exam. Don't want to be an attorney. No, thank you. I'd rather fight the attorneys. But anyway, you got a question, need some help, please feel free to contact me. If I can help you, I will. If I can't, I'll be honest and tell you I can't help you. Try to steer you in the right direction. What else do I need to say? Oh, you want to... Tell me what you want more that you want to talk about today. Today on this show, whatever you want me to do better. You want a certain topic? Let me know. Want me to stop talking about something? I don't know if I'll do that, but hey, let me know. I'll take the criticism either way. You think I sound like a moron? You think I'm an idiot? No problem. Tell me. I don't care. I really don't care. It doesn't matter to me. So you could be honest with me, and I will respond honestly back. All right, everybody. Thank you for listening. It's been the Frank Vetrell Show. I'm on every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I'll be back Friday at 4:30 right here Eastern Time on, I think I'm off Friday. But I still have, the show still rolls though on Friday, the Frank Vetrell Show, 4:30 Eastern Time. All right, well, talk about a little bit more of the normal things. I guess maybe a little Trump, what he should be doing in the first 100 days. Maybe I'll hit a little corruption, a little criminal justice. I'll start yelling a little bit. Who knows? We'll turn it up a notch. It's Friday. Then we'll all go out after the show. We'll drink some beers, right? Isn't that the pattern? All right, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for hopping on the V-Train. The next stop is justice, and I'm taking you there. Take care. Brush your hair.